guys, welcome back to my channel. For this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to do Venom. Using Elmer's glue stick, you're going to keep the brows in place, so you're just going to apply it on the brows a fair amount until you know that the brows are covered, and it's going to keep the brows down so it's easier to create the look you want without the hairs getting in the way. With a white or nude makeup crayon, all you have to do is use it to outline the shape and the details of what you would like the eye to look like, the tongue, the teeth, etc. It's easier to use something like that because if you make a mistake or you don't like the shape, you can always remove it. Using a translucent powder, I'm using RCMA's. I'm just setting the brow in place. As you can see now, I'm using the same pencil to create the shape of the mouth and the tongue. This is going to be my guideline. I'm using Maron's Paradise paint palette, but you can also use Snazaroo's colors. They come in so many shades and it'll work just as well. I actually used Snazaroo's black paint. I started off with the eye, and like I said, I'm using the lines that I have as guidelines, being sure to stay inside of those lines and not go outside of it. And if you do, you can always cover it up with the black, so don't worry. The black paint I use, like I said, is from Snazaroo, and it's their face paint, so you can go ahead and get those too, and it works just as fine, like I mentioned before. Placing the black is pretty self-explanatory. You're gonna go everywhere outside of the white. I brought it all the way down to his neck and shoulders. I covered his ear with it, his hairline, just to create that illusion. With my small detail brush, I'm going in and adding details to the eye. It's not a specific shape or detail, I'm just going to make it, give it like a ripped effect. I used two Morphe palettes to create shading and make it look a little bit more dimensional. You can use whatever eyeshadow palette you have just to create shadows and shadings. I did do this, but at the end, I realized I didn't really like how the eye looked so shaded in, and I just went over with white paint and got rid of that. That's the only difference that I did. So you guys can keep it like this if you like that effect, or just leave it all white with no details. So now I'm trying to create the shape of the teeth. I'm using a few videos and pictures as reference because I honestly didn't know who Venom was until this movie came out. So I'm just looking at pictures to get some of their ideas and looks to create mine. This is like a peachy salmon colored paint, and I'm just going in between the black face and the teeth to create gums. Again with white paint and a small like detailed brush, drawing out the teeth. It's okay if they touch or they're too long, because you can go in with the black paint and fix those details. So don't stress it. Make sure to fill in those teeth. This is what I'm using to just shade in the teeth. It's gonna give it more of a realistic look. It doesn't have to be the same palette, but if you have it, that's great. If not, if you have a mustardy yellow or a pale brown, that'll work great too. Once done with the detail of the teeth, I went in with, well, I basically mixed pink and red and white until I came up with the perfect shade for my tongue. I'm just creating the shape I want. And you'll see I go back in and like fix the shape, I add to it, I take out. It's never perfect. You just have to play along with it to see if you like it or not, or which shape best fits what you have in mind. I then went ahead and I added more teeth to the bottom of his mouth. These aren't as teardropped and perfect as the ones on the top. These look more raggedy. You're gonna go in and fill it in like you did with the top teeth. So basically everything you did to the top, you're gonna do to the bottom. You're gonna add that detail to make it look more realistic. And then the only difference is you're gonna go in with black and rim the outer area. You'll see, I'll have it in video. Again with eyeshadow, I'm going in with a dark brown close to a maroon, and I'm creating the dimension of the tongue and shading in areas and creating that shadow effect. I had no picture for this. I just went with where I thought naturally the shading would need to be. So just go with it. You'll see as you start doing it if you think it needs more certain places or not. I do use the same color to go in between the teeth. See? I went and I removed some of the tongue because I thought the tongue started to look a little big. So I'm just taking a baby wipe, or you can use a makeup remover, and I'm using my fingers to take out what I don't like. It's okay if you don't clean it up well, because you're gonna use the black to cover that up. This look is so forgiving, especially with the black. The black hides anything. This red that I'm doing right now is optional. I didn't keep this. I didn't like how it looked at the end, so I did cover it up with black. I was just trying to draw the gums a little redder as his mouth gets wider, but like I said, I didn't really like how that positioning of that red looked. But I am bringing the red inside of the tongue, in the middle of the tongue, because it is darker in the inside with the shadowing normally. Placing as much red as you like until you're happy with the amount that you have. If not, you can always go back in and add more. So I'm using a detail brush with black paint again, and I'm just going in between the teeth to create the sharpness and detail and shadowing of it. And I'm using my hand now to blend the red paint with the black paint. The warmth of your finger does help melt it in together, but I also went in with the shadow brush just to blend it and buff it out a bit, just the harsh lines. using the same pink paint that I used for the tongue, I'm just going in to create curves of the tongue. After that, I just shaded in everything else that's left with the black paint, and that's literally it. And there you have it. Just make sure you take your time to do that, and if you do mess up, go back in with a little bit with a smaller detail brush so you get the outline perfect or closer to the pink as you would like without messing it up. See, I did. I went onto the pink, but I fixed that easily. So once you've covered everything up with the black paint, you are done. And you can go out there and rock your look. I hope this video was detailed enough. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And take a look at my previous videos.